Let's say you need a new laptop, whether it's for online classes or for work, and you only have a certain budget to stick to. Usually, you'd have to choose between prioritizing internal specs or a set of good features, and sometimes you'd also want to factor in its overall design. But what if you didn't want to compromise on those three and you still want to be within your budget? That's what Realme aims to solve with the recently announced Realme Book. And with its starting price of 37,990 pesos for the Core i3 model, the company offers to deliver capable internals, a sleek design, and features that should make everyday usage more efficient and enjoyable. Hey guys, Kevin here. You're with the Modern Creatures. Welcome to another video. This is our Realme Book review. You've probably seen a lot of the Realme Book's design in our unboxing video, but let's quickly go over it once more. You do get an aluminum build with evident precise crafting. This makes the device feel more premium and a sight to look at. It easily stands out with its sort of matte and frosted finish, more so when light hits its real blue color at just the right angle. There's also real gray available if you want to keep things more neutral. Looking from its side profile, we see how it's really slim with a thin form factor. It's also light and effortless to carry from one spot to another, so when it comes to its size and footprint, this easily competes with top notebook offerings from other brands. In terms of ports, it comes with a USB-A on the right side, together with its 3.5mm headphone and audio jack combo. Meanwhile, the other side comes with two USB-C ports and one with support for Thunderbolt 4.
And with it, you're able to connect external displays if you need to boost productivity with a second monitor. But this Thunderbolt 4 port is only exclusive to the Core i5 variant. For the Core i3 model, you only get two USB-C Gen 2 ports.
Meanwhile, the keyboard has rather large keys and actually reminds me of a MacBook. The Realme Book's keyboard also comes in three brightness modes depending on your needs. They do come in handy when you're working in total darkness, but with light present, you barely notice them anyway. I was easily able to type fast thanks to the spacing of its keys and ergonomic layout. It's a bit larger than what I'm personally used to, but still easy to type on a daily basis. The touchpad also comes with a good size to it and has been easily accessible and ergonomic as well during my time with it. Although I just noticed that this specific area in the trackpad isn't really clickable. You can use it to select and open folders, for example, but it doesn't click, which I find just a bit weird.
It doesn't affect performance in any way though, just something that you might want to know.
But other than that, it's got good tactile feedback to it when in use, and its large surface area makes navigation through the laptop easy. On the upper right-hand corner, we see the power button that also serves another function. It also doubles as a fingerprint scanner for an added layer of security. This feature has been reliable for me and it works quite fast as well. I haven't experienced any hiccups unlocking the screen and getting access to my files. Looking up top, you get this webcam that's doing a great job of blending and is almost invisible. It comes with an HD resolution which is just right for video calls. The Realme Book sports a 14-inch IPS screen which the company calls its full vision display. During my time with it, its 2K resolution produced detailed picture quality that's not just great for work and crunching numbers, it also made me enjoy streaming videos and browsing photos on it. And thanks to its slim bezels that achieve 90% screen-to-body ratio, visuals also appeared more immersive while its 100% sRGB color gamut made sure that colors reproduced are faithful and natural-looking.
I personally prefer displays with a 16:9 aspect ratio simply because it suits better for video editing, but I do appreciate this device's 3:2 aspect ratio and the benefits that it offers.
With it, I'm able to benefit when writing articles or reading long pieces online as I was able to fit more content on the screen.
Similarly, I could see users who are data-driven to make the most out of this 3:2 orientation.
Adding to that, slight glares from working outside shouldn't be a problem as the screen can be adjusted to go as bright as 400 nits. It does work fine in general, but sometimes you still need to find that spot to lessen the glare to be able to see the laptop's monitor well.
As for other aspects of its multimedia, its dual Harman speakers provide audio powerful and loud enough for personal consumption or for a small group huddled around the laptop.
And with its stereo sound tweaked by DTS, its audio quality is what you'd expect from a laptop this size. It's got adequate mids, highs that add just the right details, and bass levels that are there but nothing to write home about. We'll be right back.
It's not the best sound system around on a laptop, but definitely great for its size and form factor.
Additionally, if you prefer to use a separate pair of headphones, the laptop is equipped with Bluetooth for easy pairing, so you can just put them on to listen to music or avoid feedback during video calls.
And to work hand-in-hand with its HD webcam, it also comes with AI noise cancellation, so its microphones isolate your voice better during calls.
And as established in our unboxing video, there are two available processors at the heart of the Realme Book: an 11th gen Intel Core i3 or a more powerful Core i5 like the one we have here with us. These are then partnered to 8GB of RAM and a choice of either 256GB or 512GB of SSD storage. Taking care of its graphics is an Intel Iris Xe, which is a high-performance graphics card capable of running different productivity programs and even a lot of video game titles popular today. With these running together, we've used the Realme Book for browsing with multiple tabs on, editing full HD videos on Adobe Premiere, light motion graphics and working multiple layers on After Effects,
and even playing games like Genshin Impact with its graphics settings set to moderate. Overall, the device is able to handle its own and maintain composure even after a whole day's use of all those things I just mentioned.
Not only that, it's able to do most of those while keeping its cool. I didn't notice any part of its chassis that rose in temperature even while editing.
This simply means that its system dissipates heat better, and this is largely due to the fact that Realme uses dual cooling fans, while some laptops in this price range only use a single fan.
One new technology that Realme is introducing with the Realme Book is its PC Connect. This basically allows users to use a compatible smartphone and link it to the laptop to unlock instant collaboration between the two and make certain tasks like transferring files, photos, and videos easier and seamlessly, similar to how other ecosystems work.
But as of the time of this video, only the Realme GT Master Edition is compatible with this new tech. Later on, more Realme devices will be ready to take advantage of this cross-platform collaboration.
Additionally, the Realme Book runs on Windows 10 Home and is pre-installed into the system. But you'd be glad to know that it comes with free upgrade to Windows 11 to access all its new features once it's available. Realme also throws in Microsoft Office so that you can easily accomplish work as soon as you get your Realme Book. Over at the battery department, its 54 watt-hour pack has a claimed life of 8 hours of office usage. Translating that to real-life experience that includes lots of browsing, writing, and video editing, I was able to squeeze out about 5.5 hours of average battery life before needing to charge it again. Thankfully, it supports 65 watts of fast charging, and with its included charger, I was able to fully charge the Realme Book in about 1 hour and 15 minutes from a totally empty battery pack. The company also claims a 50% battery life after charging the laptop in 30 minutes, given that the device is turned off and not in use.
Doing so, Realme's claims held true, and we were able to get a battery half full after half an hour. And as always in our reviews, The Modern Creatures aims to find special features in devices that would make them worth having. Their creature feature. And for the Realme Book, it would definitely have to be its minimalist design and real blue color.
Yes, it comes with a good display, internals that are powerful enough for your usual day-to-day tasks, and even a fast charging battery that really comes in handy. But I do really like the unique vibe that it's able to pull off with its color, specifically this real blue option. It just stands out easily and it catches your attention in a subtle way rather than going for loud, tacky colors.
It might sound superficial, cause it literally is, but judge me all you want, I really like how it looks, and I believe that alone is enough for some to notice and be interested in this laptop.
The Realme Book retails at 37,990 pesos for the Core i3 variant and 41,990 pesos for the Core i5 model.
There are exclusive deals from Lazada and Silicon Valley that will let you score these laptops for less and with freebies. We'll leave links in the description below.
And at those price points, the company has been successful to deliver capable internals, a sleek design, and features that do make everyday usage more efficient and enjoyable.
And that's about it for our Realme Book review. So what do you think of the device? And also, what do you think of our new set? Does it need something more? Let us know in the comments below. As always, visit our website and follow us on our social media pages for more news, features, and reviews. Once again, that's it for me. I'm Kevin. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.